Hey, Docker fans. Recently, I got to spend a whole week in San Francisco, and of course, while I was there, I had to spend some time at Docker headquarters. So I was lucky enough to talk with some of the engineers, the product managers, and of course, Gordon the Turtle, who, if you're not aware of, is a real-life pet turtle that is sort of Docker's mascot. He has his own Twitter handle that you can check out. But the highlight of my visit was to hang out with Swarm engineer Anshul Paneer, and we talk about the past, the present, and the future of Swarm. So in this short video, we're going to go through what he's been working on, what the team is focusing on now, and what we can hope to expect in the future for the SwarmKit libraries, as well as the Docker Swarm feature set in the engine. So if you're at all a fan of Swarm or anything Docker or DevOps, please subscribe to this channel. You can also check out my full course on Swarm at swarmmastery.com. That's where you can get the best coupon for learning quickly how to take Swarm into a production-grade cluster. But enough about all that. Let's go hang out with Anshul and learn about the future of Swarm. Anshul, thanks so much for being here.
Thanks, Brett.
We're going to talk about SwarmKit and Swarm. Sweet. And all things orchestration for Docker.
Sounds good.
So tell a little the audience about yourself, what you do here at Docker.
Definitely, yeah. Hi, everyone. My name is Anshul. I've been at Docker for almost a year now, and I'm an engineering lead on the SwarmKit team. And so you can probably tell that I've done anything and everything on SwarmKit since the day I joined.
If we go look at your PRs, we'll see that. Yeah. SwarmKit, SwarmKit, SwarmKit.
SwarmKit, all SwarmKit, all the way from renaming variables to shipping snapshots over the stream.
Nice. So SwarmKit, if people aren't aware, is a sort of built-in orchestration for Docker. It's been around a while. Why don't you give us a brief history about where it came from, where it's at?
Absolutely, yeah. So SwarmKit, as you already know, is a distributed system for managing applications at any scale. And what that means is that you can use it in a cluster environment, and you can deploy your applications in a fault-tolerant and fault-resilient manner in your cluster. So the way Swarm started out was it came out as a successor of the previous version of Swarm that we built previously, and then we applied a lot of learnings from that system into this new version. And we released it about 2 years ago at DockerCon up in Seattle.
Mm-hmm.
And some of those requirements were essentially, you know, just build a fault-tolerant, highly resilient system, but also we wanted to build ease of use into the system. And we put that DNA into Swarm back when we designed it about 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And you can see that in how you use Swarm. You can just install the engine and do Swarm in it and Swarm join, and you're ready to go. And a single engine or a single instance of Docker engine running on a node is a Swarm of one.
Yeah.
And you can easily join more Swarm, more nodes to it.
One or more.
Right.
That's really what's cool is people don't realize Swarm can be just one node. Obviously, it's not fault tolerant,
right,
but you do get cool features out of the box, like secrets, right, encrypted storage, absolutely, you know, all that cool stuff. Yeah.
Right.
I mean, I'm a big Swarm fan myself. I really appreciate how much time you all spend on ease of use and security by default and encrypted by default out of the box. That's, I think, a really important thing for the community, because we're humans, if we're given the option to not go fully secure, often we won't, right? Because it usually takes extra work, extra effort. So it's nice that the security with Swarm is actually hard to get wrong, is what I tell people.
Yeah.
So we got in the last, 6 months, it's 2018 now. In the last 6 months, Docker has released Docker EE with Kubernetes support. And that's adding Kubernetes to the existing list of orchestrators that Docker EE already supports. And maybe could you tell us a little bit about how your customers on Enterprise Edition, as well as obviously Community Edition, are using Swarm and SwarmKit today?
Yeah, definitely. So it's good that you brought up the Kubernetes integration in Docker Enterprise Edition. And I did want to mention that our strategy in orchestration is all about choice.
Yeah.
And to that end, we've integrated Kubernetes into the platform. So a lot of our customers and users love the simplicity of Swarm and continue to use Swarm. And new users continue to use Swarm as well. not just test and staging environments, but also in production. And with the Kubernetes integration, you get the option, you get to choose the orchestrator that you want to use, and you get to choose the feature sets that you want. So you can actually have workloads on both Swarm and Kube in the same cluster.
If you look at the repos, right, so Docker, the engine, obviously is built of lots of repositories on GitHub. Majority of those are open source. In Swarm, SwarmKit is the main repo, right? And then we have LibNetwork and some other repos. But if you go looking through those, you see lots of PRs and commits over the last year, but we don't hear a lot about new features coming out of the blog or anything like that. So maybe you could just catch us up to date on what's been going on this last 6 to 12 months.
Yes, a lot of work actually has been happening in the Swarm and LibNetwork area over the past year or so. A lot of this has been in areas of performance and scalability improvements. We're seeing more and more customers running deployments and workloads on Swarm in production. We're seeing Swarm pushed to newer limits, mm-hmm. and as a result, we've uncovered new challenges. And we've addressed those challenges. We worked on addressing and designing for solving those challenges.
All right, so we've got some bug fixes. We've got a bunch of learning on real world, large scale systems that your big customers are using. So what are some of the stuff that's going on right now that you can talk about that you're working on?
Probably heard of KubeMark, which is a benchmarking tool available for Kube. Mm-hmm. And we're looking to build something very similar for SwarmKit. So that's one of the things that that we're going to be working on in the next in the coming months. A few of the things that we're looking to explore are around building better storage support in Swarm. Currently, the way you would use storage in Swarm is to use Docker storage plugins.
Right.
But a lot of our users have expressed. Express the need for better integration, better storage integration within the orchestrator, which in this case is SwarmKit. So think about your workloads. Think about your storage being workload aware, and the orchestrator moving the storage as your workloads relocate or move around in the cluster. So that's something that we're looking to build. And one of the ideas we're exploring is integrating CSI, which is a container storage interface, into Swarm, which allows us to make use of the different storage drivers that are available out there, and CSI has definitely gained a lot of momentum both with Kubernetes and Mesos, because the idea is to have something that's orchestrator independent.
Yep.
So it can work across any orchestrator.
The dream of storage. Right. That it all works everywhere all the time.
Right, absolutely, yeah. We're also looking to address more and more technical debt. We're looking at more performance improvements. We're evaluating newer and better ways to do load balancing on our networking side. And we're also looking to build to support new use cases in Swarm. Use cases like machine learning and bad jobs and
GPUs, cron jobs. Yeah, and GPUs. Yeah, that's and devices. Right. I think that's cool.
Right.
Yeah. You mentioned a new resource allocator design or something that you were working on for IPs and whatnot.
Right. Absolutely. So yeah, the resource allocator is a component in SwarmKit which handles resource management.
Yeah.
So IP allocation. And all the other resources that an object in SwarmKit or a workload in SwarmKit might need.
Yeah.
So you're familiar with SwarmKit. You know that you can define services, which essentially map to applications, and services run execution units, which are called tasks.
Right.
And so every time a task is executed in SwarmKit, it needs to allocate certain IP addresses for networking. And that all goes through our resource allocator. And so based on our experience running SwarmKit over the last 2 years, we noticed that was one of the components which was breaking quite often.
Mm.
Studying it, this was the work done by Drew Ernie. He went back and then looked at...
Hi, Drew.
Give it a good work. And he studied the design and he proposed some improvements and it turned out that the best way to do that would be to actually re-implement it, redesign and re-implement it. And we did that and the PR is actually available on Swarmkit GitHub. So
yeah.
For those who are interested, please go check it out.
Well, that sounds like a lot of stuff going on with Swarm. It sounds super exciting for us to get some of the fixes and the code debt out of the way and start to focus on some of these new things that I'm sure you guys will be talking about here later this year at DockerCon EU and going forward as you release new Docker editions or new versions of Docker. So thanks again for stopping by and having this little chat in Docker HQ with all the Mobi swag and everything around us. And I look forward to seeing you on the next little hangout that we do talking about Swarm.
Thanks for having me, Brett. Just a reminder, the Swarmkit team is growing. It's a very diverse and distributed team. We have people in San Francisco. We have people in the Midwest, on the East Coast. And out in Europe, we have people in Norway, in Cambridge, in Paris. So we are growing. We are hiring in all of these different locations, in San Francisco and Seattle. So if you're interested in working on a large-scale distributed systems and solving complicated challenges or complex challenges, then please go to dockers.com/careers.
Nice. I'm going to go check it out. All right, I'll see you soon.
Thanks, Brett.
Thanks.